I'm gonna be sharing with you a full face of products that quickly became my favorites, and they're new products, and I don't think I've ever shown them on my channel before. I'm excited to share these with you. Let's get into this video. Hello everyone, I am so happy that you're here with me today. I am sharing with you a full face of products that have recently come into my arsenal and that they have quickly become favorites of mine. The other thing that I'm really excited about is that this video is a collaboration with my very dear friend Kimberly from Pretty Over 50. You probably already know Kimberly. She came onto the scene here on YouTube a couple of years ago and she just exploded. And I truly believe that is because her personality is so kind and nurturing, and I personally could listen to her talk all day long. She just has this very calm nature about her, and besides that, she's gorgeous inside and out. And so if you have not had a chance to see her, I would love for you to go over and show her some love and tell her I sent you and see what she has picked out for her new favorites. I can't wait to see that myself. Kimberly covers so many topics for the over 50 woman: skincare, lifestyle, fashion, hair, tons of makeup. She just does all kinds of things. And she will tell you that the reason that she started her YouTube channel was to see if you could create a change in skin that had kind of been neglected, because she says that hers had been neglected for many years. And she has done that. Her skin is gorgeous. And so I really encourage you to go over and check out as many of her videos as you can. She puts out content all the time, and she puts out very quality content too. Now, if you did come over from Kimberly's channel to see me, I want to say thank you so much for joining me. I'm Melissa, and I have been on YouTube now for 6 years, and I just love what I do. I actually started my channel with the thought that I just needed somewhere to put my energy, because I actually became disabled at the time and was not able to work outside the home. And so this was a way for me to keep busy, since I had worked my whole life, and yet it was still a hobby enough that it could work into my illness, to where I could do it from my bed if I needed to, and then I could do it on days when I felt good, and days when I didn't have to. Wouldn't have to be held to a schedule of 9 to 5 or have to be somewhere every single day. But this has turned into an absolute passion for me, and it has become my career or my job, and I adore it. So my channel is again based for the older woman over 50 with more mature skin. And mostly I have up to this point done a lot of makeup from the drugstore and how that compares to what you could get for high end. And I have recently been able to purchase a few more high-end things. I've gotten my channel going enough that I can do that. So I'm also starting to compare a lot of high-end things. So I'm excited where my channel is going. I hope that you do decide to subscribe. Please give it a thumbs up, everyone, if you wouldn't mind. I would love to have you here. Let's get into this video. Okay, so this one from MAC is kind of dear to me, and I'll tell you why. It is the MAC Prep and Prime Skin Refined Zone Treatment. This is a primer, and I recently found this primer because of Mel, and I have been rewatching her videos so much since she's gone now. And I had stumbled across this video where Mel talked about hidden gems, or things that really make a difference. I will try to link that video because it was so good. It was full of so many good products. There's a few that you can't get anymore, but there was a lot in there that were really helpful to me. This one from MAC, she talked about this being just a treatment just on the problem areas where you have huge pores. And I do have huge pores right in through here. As my skin ages, it's starting to sag a little bit, and it makes those pores look a little bit bigger. So I'm just targeting my really huge pores, and I will just take a tiny dot of this and just press it right into those areas and then pat it around. I do it on my chin, my nose, and right here in between my eyes, just to get those pores a little bit more refined before I even do primer. So yes, this is an extra step, but I do feel like it's a step that when you're wanting to have a perfected look, this is amazing, and it's become a favorite very quickly. And then another one that became a favorite very quickly was the Revlon Photo Ready Prime Prime Plus Perfecting and Smoothing. This one is makeup and skincare together. And this has in it really good ingredients anyway, but it is really an awesome primer for not having that thick silicone feel or dimethicone feel that most of these do have. Now this one does, but it still feels like it's a bit watery. It's quite thin enough that it just glides across the skin. And then as it's going into the skin, it just begins to feel like silk. I love using this as a primer. My foundation lays so beautiful over it, and it just presses into the skin and just makes that foundation look just seamless across my skin, and I love this so much. And then the next thing that I do on my face after I do that is my eyes. I used my tried and true Anastasia Beverly Hills eyeshadow primer. I don't use any other eyeshadow primer, so I don't have a new one of those to show you, but I do want to show you the rose quartz. Now, I have talked about this palette from Huda Beauty on my channel before, but I am wearing it today, and I will kind of flash away to a little bit of a demo. This is absolutely stunning. This palette has just stolen my heart so quickly. The reason for that, more than anything, is the textures are different in here. There's different tones. There's different ways to wear this. Like, if you were somebody that really loved warm and you weren't real drawn to the cool tones, these six right here are quite warm tones. And so you could stick with that, maybe throw in a little bit of this. But for it being like a lavender, pink, purple, oh my goodness. Now today I have this color right here on my lid, along with this color as well in the inner lid. I took this color and this color mixed together, which is a pink and a mauve, a darker mauve, and I did that as my transition color, and then I went over here into this color for the deepening up of the outer crease, and then I went into this color and the darkest color, which is right here, and I did my bottom eyeliner right there in the corner. I love this palette. It is so unique. It's so special. I also took some of this color right here and put it in the inner corner and then just dusted it just a little bit to make that look come together. It's so pretty. There's so many textures in this, and it is just a stunner. If you've been thinking about it, but you didn't know whether or not you really wanted it, this is one of her palettes. This is probably the new nudes, and this one are my very favorites that she's ever done. Everything else always seemed to be a bit too warm for me. Even Mercury in Retrograde, I wasn't as impressed as I was with that one. Okay, moving on to foundation. I think it was That Girl Shay's channel that I heard about this Urban Decay Stay Naked Weightless Liquid Foundation. This is so pretty. I have this on today. Obviously, I have everything on today that I'm going to be talking about. This is for me at one coat. It is like a light medium coverage. At two coats, it builds up enough that it gives me the complete coverage that I like, but it still looks like skin. I feel like it is so gorgeous. It lays across my skin just absolutely flawlessly. It covered everything I wanted it to. It evened out my skin tone. The very first time I wore this, I knew that I was going to be in love with it. Now I'm completely in love with it after having it for a while. It is beautiful, and the color is spot on for me. I really have been enjoying this, and I actually got a tinted foundation as well, and I like it too, but I think I like this one just a little bit more. Now, this one isn't a new product to my channel. I've been talking about it for about a month now, ever since I got them, but the Kosas Revealer Concealers, I am so in love with these because I had completely given up on concealer because of the creasing and how old it made me look underneath my eyes right here. And so when I got this, I was very, very skeptical, but I knew almost immediately that it was different from anything else that I had tried before. And so I have it in two shades. I have it in my shade, which I think is called Cool Cashmere. And then I have it in their very lightest shade. And the reason that I put the very lightest shade on with this one is I will put a dot out here of my regular shade that matches my skin. And then inside I will put a dot of the very, very lightest. And I learned that trick from Spencer, from Painted by Spencer. I was watching him do that to an older gal, and it brought so much light to her area right here. And I was just blown away at how bright she looked. And so that is what this does for me. And together, the two of them are perfect. I will just blend them. I don't put them on at separate times. I'll put a dot of this one and a dot of this one, and then I'll just blend them. It has kind of an unassuming doe foot applicator. It's not too big, it's not too little. Nothing very special about it, but what the product is so special, and I am absolutely positively in love with that. Then I have two products to talk about, one for contour and one for bronzer. You could use this product from Iconic London for your bronzer if you wanted to, and not just have it just as your contour, because it is pretty enough to be able to do that. And this is the Precision Duo Contour Pot, and this one is in medium shadow. You have in here two products. You have a cream product on the bottom, and then you have a powdery product on the top. But I am here to tell you that that powder product is so soft and so buttery that it almost could be a cream. It's just amazing. And then the cream, it just melts into your skin. So I layered the cream underneath the powder and I'm in love with it. And then I want to tell you that I got this brush from Ulta. This is a lot like that concealer brush and the BK Beauty foundation brush. And it is considered a precision foundation brush from the Ulta line. But this is so good for laying down that line of contour and then up into my hairline, across my jawline, and then I just take it and I just keep buffing with it. It's very soft and I really love this style of brush. Every time I see this style of brush after Angie Hot and Flashy came out with it, with her line with BK Beauty, I have picked one up every time and I'm in love with this. It's so great for putting down this product, and this product from Iconic London, amazing, just beautiful. I know that it's a little bit more, but that is just something special in these two little pots. I really have been loving it so much. And then from Laura Geller, I had this way back in the day before I even started my YouTube channel, and this is her Baked Bronze in Brighton, and this one is in Fair. And the reason that I like this so much is that the marbling in here isn't yellow, it's a pink, and so it makes fair skin like mine that has that cool tone look like I've got a bronzer on me, not something orange like Oompa Loompa skin. It's just beautiful. It is absolutely gorgeous. It's not, now I just used that same finger, so I'm gonna switch fingers. It's not one that gives you this super duper orange. It kind of is more on the red side because that pink's in it, and that's what I love about it. And it warms up my face beautifully. It blends beautifully. I love Baked products. I think that they are really good on mature skin. They are dry powder products, but they're not drying. And I think that's really beautiful about this powder as well. Love it. And then I think I may have shown this on my channel before, the Born to Go from NYX. This is the liquid illuminator. Such a tiny bit of this goes a long way, and it is liquid. So I will always put it on my hand like that, and then I'll spread it across and then put a brush into it, and it just is beautiful. As you know, if you've been here for very long, I put my highlighter underneath my blush in order for it to just look seamless. Instead of just looking like a beaming highlighter, it looks like a glow. And this one goes beautiful underneath my blushes. And it just takes such a teeny tiny amount for it to spread across your skin and just make your skin look so beautifully glowing, and that lip from within, just gorgeousness. I love it. And then as well, I also got a new shade. This is not a new blush formula to me, but this shade is new to me, and this one is called Cheeky. These are her, I think they're her cheek, I can't remember what they're called. I'll put it up on the screen. What I love about this color, this is so neutral. That is such a neutral blush. It is what I have on today. I feel like that blush would go with a warm tone, neutral, cool, purples, blues, whatever you wore on your eye, if it was oranges, whatever. I feel like this blush would blend in so pretty, and it did a great job across my skin. Again, this is one that just lays gorgeous. It tints your skin, and you don't have to have too much on there. It can be built up to be a lot like this, or you can sheer it out to where it's just a tiny wash of color depending on what you really like. I don't remember whether it was Macy's or Ulta, but somebody had the sale on the Studio Fix makeup, and Lisa J had just done a video on their foundation, and so I picked up their foundation while I was there. I picked up their powder foundation as well, and I stumbled across the perfect color because that is so confusing to me. When I try to pick their colors, it is so confusing. And this one is N4, so a neutral 4. This is perfect color for me. What I love about this powder is how super creamy it is. It is a little bit more powder than I would normally wear, but what I've been using it for more than anything is to go in this area right here that I just can't cover with foundation or even concealer. And that powder foundation over that is helping with those dark, dark age spots of mine. And this is working so well. I am very impressed with it. And the other thing is that once you get it into your skin, it will melt into your skin, melt with your makeup without making you look cakey. It is beautiful. And then if you need to touch up during the day, you have that touch up, but you won't look dry because it is the foundation that just melts. I mean, it's beautiful. It's really beautiful on the skin. And I have been so lax about trying any MAC products. I don't know why, because I know that MAC has been the rage for, I don't know, years and years, probably 20 or more years. And I just haven't had a chance to try that many, but I will be trying some now because between the foundation and this foundation powder, they're really, really good. Also, this powder from Physicians Formula, the Rose All Day Set and Glow Powder. This one is so pretty. I love this duo. And I think I may have talked about this before on my channel too. Maybe not. I can't ever remember. This is a balm on this side. So I'll tell you what I would do if it were me with this. I would take this powder, which I use this powder. Isn't that a beautiful little rose embossing in there? So gorgeous. I take this powder, which is super fine, and it does not get a lot on your finger. I know I rubbed my finger really well in there, but when you're using a brush, there's hardly any that comes up, so it's going to be really soft and glowy. You know the Milani Prep Set and Glow? That's what this powder is right here. It might be just a tiny, tiny bit more glowy, but I like that because what I will do is I will use it in specific areas, just in this area right here to give a lot of light, which is what I've done today. So I have the Kosas on, which is giving a lot of light to this area in my eyes, but then just barely in the middle here, I have this powder on. And what I thought, since this is a newer one to me, what I thought is, although this is a balm, what I thought I would do is in the summertime, I'm gonna take this and use it on my cheeks just a little bit. It might even be better in the winter because, you know, balms are something that really help with dry skin. So it might be something that you wanna think about using in the winter, and it would just give a wet look to your skin or your cheeks. So pretty, just really beautiful on that. Next is one that I actually learned about from Kimberly, which I'm so excited about. This is from Revlon, and it is one of my latest finds for their brow products, and it's the ColorStay Brow Creator. And let me see if I can find out what color I have mine in. Mine is in gray brown, and I found that this was really good for me because my natural color of my hair, kind of that mousy brown color. So it has a spoolie on one end, which we appreciate, right? And then it has the tiny precision applicator. What I like about this a little bit more is it's a little bit more of a stiff product than a lot of those micro fine ones. The reason I like that so well is because I have to make a lot of strokes to get my brows looking pretty good, because what happens is my hands shake so much that I can't just draw a line. So this one is a little bit stiffer, and I can just continue to build it up, and it won't go on there all at once, and then I have a mess because my hands were shaking and they might have gotten out of control a little bit. But the bonus for me is this in here. So you have a little spring loaded stopper shadow right there. And for me, because this eyebrow right here, I have a half eyebrow right there. And for me to be able to fill that eyebrow in and make it look natural with that little bit of shadow is such a great thing. And I love this product. I love the concept of it. I love the way they did it. And I think it's great. It stays all day. It defines the hair. It makes my brows look great, especially with my disability of my shaking hands. It's really good. Glitzy Fritzy Mary. If you don't know Mary, I will try to link all of these channels I've been talking about. They influence me just like they influence you guys. So she talked about how the Benefit Brow Setter was the only thing, and I don't think that's the exact name of it. Maybe it is. Oh, it is. I got it right. 24-hour Brow Setter from Benefit. She talked about how this is the only thing that keeps her eyebrow hair in place like glue. And she says that she's tried so many different things and I hadn't tried it. And it was on sale for like less than half off at Sephora and I grabbed it and I love it. Because on this eye, again, with this brow right here, it will stick down like this. And halfway through the day, it doesn't matter what kind of a brow setter I use, it will be sticking down. With this, it stays up. I love this. It is almost like putting glue into your eyebrows. But it comes off very easy at night. So this has been a great product for me. For lashes, I'm not gonna tell you that this is one of my new favorites, but I am going to tell you about it because it is what I have on and it is a newer product. Now, this is from Revlon and it's the So Fierce Eyes Wide Open. No smudge, I think it's no smudge or smudge proof or something like that of the mascara. It is what I have on. It builds up your lashes really well. It does a great job. And I can even put a little bit more on right now. And what I like about this is I'm gonna have this on at the end of the day. And I hardly ever wear anything but the Benefit They're Real on my bottom lashes. And I can wear this and it doesn't smudge, which makes me so happy. I love that it doesn't smudge. So this is still in the testing process of long-term, but it is like, I would say like maybe a 7 to an 8 out of a 10. And I really like it. Now, what I'm wearing on my lips today is my new favorite combo, which I'm absolutely in love with. This is from NYX. This is a one of their very cheap pencils. I think it's like $4 in prune. I think it's the slim pencil in prune. And it is kind of a purpley red color. It's very matte. I like that it stays around a long time. And I like that I can build it up to wherever I want it to. And then I'm wearing this Revlon lipstick. This is a new one as well. These are called the New Mattes. And this one is in Make It Pink. It's a very powdery matte lipstick. But the color saturation is so good. And when it mixes with that liner, it makes a beautiful color, an absolutely beautiful color. And so I will just pat my lips together until I get it to where it gets mixed together very well, or I'll dab my finger across it and mix it together. And then I found these. These are the Revlon Super Lustrous, the glosses. These are 5 lip glosses. I don't want to speak out of turn here and tell you something wrong, but when I bought these were less than $4 a gloss because they were on a special on Amazon. And I got these 5 glosses and they are so gorgeous. So I have on this very sparkly pink color today. This one is just a creamy pink. These are quite sheer. They remind me very, very much of the Fenty gloss bombs. This one is like a beautiful mauve, almost a rose, deep rose mauve. And then you have a very clear, just a shimmer. And then you have kind of a nude pink in there. So pretty. I have worn all of these and I love all of these so much, but I wanted to show you the packaging and the way they came in case you wanted to give them for a gift. They feel so luxurious on the lips. They're so nice. And I don't know if you're going to be able to see this or not, but right there down in the doe foot applicator is a little well. When it does come out, you're going to get a little bit more product. I hadn't tried these. I don't believe. Sometimes I try things and then I forget. And sometimes I repackage things and I think I hadn't tried them and I tried them in the old packaging, which could be the case of this, but these are really, really good. I really like these. And that is the end. The lips are the end of the full face. And I hope that you did enjoy the video. I hope that you do get a chance to go over and see Kimberly's video because that's where I'm headed myself right now, is to see her video. I can't wait to see what she came up with. She is a doll. You guys are gonna love her. Please show her some love. If you're new here, welcome, welcome. I hope you subscribe. My faithful followers, I am so very glad you're here. Now, I would love to get a conversation going with all of you about what you have found lately that became your new favorite. I would love to hear anything that you have like that. It doesn't even have to be makeup or skincare or beauty. if you have a new cheese you like, if you have a new pair of slippers you like, I would love to hear about that. I hope that you all take care of yourselves. I love you very much, and I'll catch you all in my next video. Goodbye, my friends.